Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. First of all, a very happy new year. Today, I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of PyCharm on a Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily run a simple Hello World Python program on our PyCharm IDE. So do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues, you can always put a comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. And I have started a couple of YouTube channels. So one is Geeky Script. So here I'm going to post coding related videos. So you can go and subscribe this channel to learn more about coding. And I have also started a vlogging channel, so which is Geeky Script Vlog. So this channel also is going to subscribe. I have recently put one dull deck short video. So you can, you know, subscribe and watch my vlogging video as well if you're interested. I'll be putting both the links in our description. Now to install PyCharm, you need to first simply open a new tab, and here you need to just simply type PyCharm download and hit enter. And this will show you this download PyCharm. So you need to open that link and it's going to redirect to the official site of PyCharm. So this link again I am going to put right in our description, so you can directly go to this link to come to this site. And once you are here, you'll be able to see that we are in the official site of JetBrains. So here, if you see that we are currently using Windows, so it is selected Windows. If you are using macOS or Linux, you need to switch to these tabs, you need to download the respective version. So I'm going to switch to Windows, and here we can see that we have PyCharm Professional one. So this Professional one is a paid one. So if you scroll down, you'll be able to see PyCharm Community Edition. So this Community Edition is the one that I'm going to download. So you need to also do click on this download button, and it's going to start getting downloaded on our system. So here you can see it is rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll just simply cancel that. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that we have already PyCharm rightly downloaded over here. So you need to just simply double click on the installer to install it locally on our system, and it's going to ask you that the app that you're trying to install isn't a Microsoft verified app, which is totally fine. You can just simply click on install anyway, so that we can start installing our PyCharm, and you can minimize your download directory, and there you go. So it will ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes. And it's going to show you this welcome note. So welcome to PyCharm Community Edition setup. So let's click on next over here. And this is our destination folder. So this is where our PyCharm is going to be installed, and you need to have 1.6 gigabyte of free space on our C drive. All right. If you want to change this destination, you can always click on browse and you can change the location. I'm going to keep this default. Right. And I'm going to click on next. So here under installation options, you can see that we have some checkboxes. So first thing, I'm going to select the desktop shortcut, and I'm also going to select this add open folder as project. So what it will do is, let's say we have a Python project lying over here. If you just simply right click on that folder, it's going to additionally give you this open folder as project option over there. So that will, you know, help you to open any folder, you know, at PyCharm very easily. So for that we have this checkbox. Then I'm going to select .py. .py basically means Python. So create associations with Python. And here, this is very important. You need to, you know, check this add bin folder to path. So what it will do is it's going to, you know, set our path in our environment variable. So they automatically do that. Only thing is you need to restart your system. I'm going to show you when you need to restart your system. You don't need to worry. So you need to select all this and click on next over here. And when you do that, it's going to show you this JetBrains folder. Fine. You can just simply click on install over here, and it's going to start installing our PyCharm. So here you can see that our PyCharm desktop shortcut is also created over here. So let's wait for a couple of minutes to get it finished install. And once it gets installed, I'm going to again come back to this video. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that it is telling that completing PyCharm Community Edition setup. So our install is successful. So what you need to do is you need to select this reboot now and then to click on finish to restart your system. So, you know, after restarting your system, let's come back to this video again. So welcome back. So after successfully restarting, your system will be again landed over to our desktop. So here you can see that our desktop shortcut is created over here. So just simply double click on the shortcut to open it. So it will ask you to import old settings. So if you have previously installed, then you can select this one, or else if you are installing it for the first time, just simply select this do not import settings and click on OK. So it will also ask you to give allow permission to firewall, which is fine. Just simply hit on allow and you're going to give all the permission to for firewalls. So and here you can see welcome to PyCharm. So let's maximize it. So this is our interface of our PyCharm. You can always click on this plus icon to create a new project. So first it's going to show you this new project window. So here before you give a project name, I'm going to talk about this Python version. Here you can see, so here if you just simply click on this drop down, you can see that we have lot many Python versions, right? Among that, the latest version is Python 3.12.0. so if you have previously already installed Python following my other video, you might see that path is rightly showing over here. So if you haven't installed Python, then also is fine. From here also you can install Python. So you need to select the desired version that you want to install and keep it over here. And after that, you need to give your project name. So let's give the project name as so currently they have given a Python project, so I'm going to change that with hello world. And here I'm also going to select this create a main.py welcome script, and after that I'm just going to click on create. So once we do that, it's going to first install our Python, as Python is not installed. So first thing that it need to do is you need to install Python. So here you can see it is downloading our Python and it's going to install it locally on our system. So you need to have active internet connection for that, right? So we can see it telling about 1 minute left. So after we done installing Python and after our project gets properly open our PyCharm, I'm going to come back to this video. So welcome back, and you can see that our project is rightly opened. So currently it is indexing all dependencies. So let's wait for some time to again get it finished. And there you go, you can see everything is done. So our project is properly opened. So here is our hello world project, and here is our main.py file. So let's maximize it. So this is our sample code they have also given. So if you do, just simply click on this run button, it's going to start building our project, and after get successfully built, it's going to show you the output hi PyCharm. So here is our print hi method. So this print hi method definition is over here. So print hi, we are passing this name as a parameter. So this string PyCharm is going over there, and this name gets printed here, right? This name gets populated with whatever value you are passing. So finally it's going to print hi, then the PyCharm, so the value that you are passing. So let's see, you change this PyCharm with hi Geeky Script, and you click on this again run button, it's going to again start building our project, and after it successfully get build it, it's going to run and it's going to show you the output hi Geeky Script, right? So whatever string you are passing over here, it's going to print that simply. So you can clear everything and you can start writing your project. So whatever project probably you have got from your school or college, you can just simply get start with our PyCharm. And as I have mentioned, you can also follow our Geeky Syntax channel for more coding related videos. You can always subscribe, and if you're interested, you can also watch our Geeky Script vlogging videos, right? So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please do like, share and subscribe, that really help me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.